Great. And then on the border, of course,
Was it no? Mm-hmm. Well, I'm not trying to be, there's a doctor who travels with him. He was walking around, as you all saw, by the end of the day. So I'm just trying to be completely transparent. He's absolutely fine. As he was on Friday, was this weekend. He spent the weekend at Camp David. He's good. Go ahead.
Okay. On the border, you said a few times today that the majority of migrant families are turned away. DHS said last month that number was 42%. That's down significantly from, say, last October when it was over 90%. So what's your threshold for the majority?
The majority of people, families, everybody who comes to the border, if you look at those overarching numbers, is turned away. DHS is the right authority for specific numbers and data on all that front. So I'd certainly encourage you to keep talking to them.
So also, you are opening up new facilities. One of the options that's being reported over the weekend is spending $86 million on hotel rooms for some migrants and feeding them. How do you square that with the National Guard troops who were sleeping in parking garages and, you know, some of them got sick from having contaminated food? That's a disparity a lot of people are pointing out, that our National Guard was treated one way and then illegal immigrants are going to be put in hotel rooms.
Well, first let me say that at the time when we became aware of the conditions National Guard troops were in parking garages, as you noted, the president called the head of the National Guard that day and offered his assistance, offered to play any role that he could play, boosting morale, asking for more aid, making sure they had the right, were treated in the way that they deserved for the incredible role they've played. So I know that was some time ago, but that was the reaction he took at the time.
If I may, one more.